Hey, remember that time when Jesus borrowed a donkey because apparently the gas prices were just as high in the first century as they are today? And then they started this huge party and lost their minds and started ripping tree branches off of trees and were all crying, Hosanna? How many of you know we like to party at church? Amen? But why did the crowd gather? That's the question. And why, out of all of the things that they could have possibly said, did they cry out, Hosanna? Well, in John's gospel and no other gospel, we get the clue as to the reason why the crowds gathered. That clue is in verse 18 of our reading. Look at what it says. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they had heard he had done this sign. That's it. That's the clue that we get as to the reason why they gathered. Now, it doesn't say these signs. So it wasn't like they were going there because they wanted to see a whole bunch of miracles. No, instead it's in the singular. It was a miracle. It was this sign. Now, all the Gospels have the donkey, they have the crowds, they have the hosannas, but this Gospel only tells us why. And the sign also explains the reason why they cried out, Hosanna. Now, this sign was the raising of Lazarus from the dead. That was the miracle. The raising of Lazarus from the dead is the reason why they had gathered. Now, think about it. Chronologically, the raising of Lazarus from the dead is literally the event that occurs just before Jesus' triumphal entry. So the whole event, the whole gathering of the crowd was all because of Lazarus. That's why they gathered. They wanted to witness if it was true. If the man who had been dead for 4 days was really walking around alive and marching into Jerusalem with Jesus. But once they verified the rumors, their attention quickly shifted. Their interest was no longer in the one who had been raised from the dead, but the one who can raise the dead. After meeting Jesus, they were certainly not left unaffected. And this is why they cried, Hosanna. Because did you know that the word Hosanna means save us? Save us is what they were crying. They wanted to meet the one who can save them from the power of death. Hosanna means save us. And when they cried that out, it's as if they were crying out, save me! Save me as well. Crowd gathered because they wanted to be near enough to borrow the glory. They wanted to have a Lazarus-like story as well. But there were some that wanted to stop Lazarus that day. Did you know that? Did you know that the religious leaders were trying to put Lazarus back in a tomb? Did you know that? It happens just 3 verses before our reading. I'll go ahead and read it to you. It says this. When the large crowd of Jews learned that Jesus was there, they came not only on account of him, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had risen from the dead. So the chief priests made plans to put Lazarus to death as well, because on account of him, many had believed in Jesus. See, the Pharisees, they were just wringing their hands about all of this ability to contain this problem. They wanted to get Lazarus back into a tomb. But once they saw Jesus on that borrowed burrow, Lazarus wasn't so much of a problem as Jesus was. To them, Jesus was clearly being Davidic, acting all Zechariah 9:9-ish. And coming in like Solomon did on David's donkey in 1 Kings chapters 1 and 2. He was sending a political message. He was too dangerous. They had a Jesus problem. And if you listen to what they said at the end of our reading for today, you would hear that worry in them. They said, you see that we are gaining nothing. Look, the whole world is coming out after him. So now their plans had shifted. Now they needed to put Jesus into a tomb. And that's exactly what they did. They took all of their wits, they took all of their strength, they took all of their power, all of their political chicanery, and they put Jesus into a spot where he couldn't wriggle free from them like he had done so many times before. They got him into a spot where he could be executed publicly, shamed as they stripped him bare, beat him, and put him on the cross, and then finally they can contain the problem by sticking Jesus dead in a tomb. But that's when their real problem began. Because apparently, if you put the one who raises Lazarus from the grave into a tomb, he can rise too! There's so many problems in our text. The problem for the religious leaders is that you can't stop Jesus. Can I get an amen to that? And thank God for that, right? Am I right? Listen, if you have a problem with sin, if you have a problem with suffering, if you have a problem with separation or with hurt or with pain or with brokenness or with deliverance, if you need help with that, you can't stop Jesus from helping you. So whatever you, like the crowd, came today, the thing that you are crying Hosanna for, Jesus is strong enough to save you. You can put your faith and your trust in him. Now, what about the problem with the crowd? The problem with the crowd is that they came for glory, and all they got was the cross. And that must have been pretty underwhelming, don't you think? Jesus comes in, trashes the place, you know, he teaches some teachings that changes people's lives. He then goes out and he's betrayed by his closest constituents, and he goes through this kangaroo court where he's bounced around, and then finally he suffers and dies publicly, humiliated in death. That was it. If the crowd came for glory, all they got was the cross. That's kind of hard, isn't it? But what they couldn't understand is what they would need faith to see. What they couldn't understand is what they would need faith to see. Hosanna wasn't going to be for the glory and the hype. Hosanna was going to be for what he did on the cross. That's how he saved us. Because our problem isn't with the symptoms of the problems of our life, but our problem is a problem with death and its cause. The cause of death is sin. Don't you know the verse? For the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God, that's eternal life. Let's read together John 5:24. Let's put it up on the screen. Read this together with me. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life. He does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life. Everybody comes for glory. But you must follow Jesus in the way of the cross in order to see what makes Easter truly great. The problem sometimes with Holy Week for us is that we come for the Sundays and we skip past the other events that happened that week. There's a way in which we, like the crowd, love a good party. We love to celebrate. Anybody with me? It's okay. It's not a bad thing. And if you're here this weekend, you'll get a celebration of Palm Sunday, and if you're here next Sunday, you'll get Easter, and that's a party also. And listen, how many of you are like, I came for the party. I came for the cake. Am I right? And so keep all that bitter stuff away from me. But the buttercream is only sweet because of what happened on that week that we call holy. I want to encourage you to show up for Monday, Thursday, even Good Friday, because it puts our hosannas into its proper perspective today. We want him to do for us what he did for Lazarus. We want him to save us, to save me. But we will only get that through the cross. That's how our celebrations get the victory that we long for so much. If we needed victory, it happened with Christ, who dealt with our real problem of sin on the cross. That's what makes our hosannas right. But I know, and I know I probably shouldn't say it, but the problem with Good Friday is that it's kind of a bummer, amen? Kind of feels like the end, right? But I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this. Remember what Lazarus was to that crowd that gathered on that first Palm Sunday. He is a living reminder that you can't stop Jesus. Remember this. You can't stop Jesus. Will you say that with me? You can't stop Jesus. He's on his way to deal with our real problem of sin, and you can't stop Jesus. And even if you were to put him into a tomb, he would rise again. And if he has risen, so will you and all who believe by his name. Today, I want to invite you to take the perspective of Lazarus this Palm Sunday as one who was a dead friend of Jesus who has been raised from the power of sin and death to life again, and who gets the privilege to witness Jesus' mighty power to save. In his name, amen.